you've probably heard about the G7 Summit. You know, the group of world leaders that meet every year to discuss big issues and pose for an obligatory photo op. But what about the G8 and G20? Is there a difference, and do they really matter? In short, yes. The G7 actually started as G6, and for a little while, it was G8. This is the group that talks about the problems in the world at large, while the G20, a newer and bigger group of leaders, deals mostly with money, or economic cooperation. Confused? Don't be. Let's go back to the start. After the first oil shock of the 1970s, economies across the world were suffering, and global leaders wanted to do something about it. So a group of government officials decided to meet up and figure things out. At first, it was just six countries: France, Germany, Italy, Japan, the US, and the UK. The next year, Canada joined and G7 was formed. In 1998, Russia joined the club, making it the G8. But it was kicked out in 2014 after its annexation of Crimea. So now we're back to G7. The countries and attendants typically discuss broad issues like climate change, jobs of the future, and women's empowerment. However, the G7 is an informal group, so what's said during meetings isn't binding. They're more of an opportunity for leaders to exchange ideas. But there are some other notable global powers missing from the G7 table, like China and India, which has led some to say the group isn't representative of the world powers at large. Which brings us to this, a bigger, more inclusive group of world powers. The G20 got its official start in 1999 after a series of global financial crises. All of the G7 countries and Russia were invited, along with financial leaders from another 11 countries and the EU. As of 2018, G20's members represent 85% of global economic output. But some critics still see it as unrepresentative of the world's population. So, G7 is mainly politics. It was only called G8 when Russia was involved. The G20 is mainly money, and it's made up of way more countries. But if there's one thing you can count on from both summits, it's a good old-fashioned family photo.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.